Sadhguru is a realized yogi and mystic who works tirelessly towards the physical, mental, and spiritual well-being of all. With a unique ability to make the ancient yogic sciences relevant to contemporary minds, Sadhguru acts as a bridge to the deeper dimensions of life. His approach does not ascribe to any belief system, but offers methods for self-transformation that are both proven and powerful. Sadhguru's transformational programs have deeply touched the lives of millions worldwide. A prolific author, poet, and internationally renowned speaker, his wit and piercing logic provoke and broaden our thoughts and perception of life. Named one of India's 50 most influential people, Sadhguru has been a leading voice at major global forums, including the United Nations, World Economic Forum, the UK House of Lords, TED, and the top business schools and universities around the world, among many others. Sadhguru established Isha Foundation, a non-profit organization supported by over 3 million volunteers worldwide. From powerful yoga programs to large-scale humanitarian projects for rural upliftment, education for the underprivileged, environmental restoration, as well as holistic and healthy living. The Foundation's activities are designed to create an inclusive culture and establish global harmony.
Years ago, in the upper regions of Himalayas, a yogi appeared. Nobody knew where he came from, his antecedents were unknown, but he looked extraordinary, so people gathered. They waited, they thought he's going to perform some miracle, but he did nothing, simply he sat. Unmoving. People left. Only 7 people hung on. These 7 people recognized that this is a fantastic miracle because only someone who has transcended the physical nature can simply sit. Then they begged him, "You seem to be knowing or experiencing something that we cannot imagine. Please teach us." Then he gave them some few simple preparatory methods and said, "You prepare yourself, let me see." They went on preparing themselves. Months went into years, years went into decades. 84 years passed. One day, when the shift of solstice happened, the sun's relationship with the planet changes. When these changes happen, every yogi makes some adjustment within himself because something about your body changes at that time. So when he was making this, he just looked. These 7 people had become shining receptacles. 84 years, he had completely forgotten about them. Here they were, still preparing. Then Because nobody knew his name, he never introduced himself. They called him Adi Yogi. Adi Yogi means the first yogi. Now, because the sun turned south, he also faced south and sat down. So they called him the Adi Guru. The first guru was born. This was considered the most significant day because it's in this day humanity was first reminded the simple laws of nature are not permanent restrictions. If you're willing to strive, you can go beyond that. And he not only gave this idea, he gave methods as to how to get there. And when all the seven people attained, he told them to go away to faraway lands. So one he sent to Central Asia, another he sent to North Africa, another he sent to South America, another he sent to Far East Asia, another stayed back with him, another came down to what is called as the present Indian Himalayas, another he sent him down to South India. He is very important for us, that is Agastya Muni, who is known as the father of Southern mysticism. Agastya Muni came down south, south of India. Every human habitation in this part of the world, he made sure spiritual process became a natural way of living. So these seven sages took this different dimensions of yoga, and even today you can see the remnants of what they did thousands of years ago, present in every culture across the planet. The word yoga means union. Union means right now, it is a scientific fact today that this existence is just one energy manifesting in many different ways. When Einstein says E is equal to mc squared, he's talking about it is all the same energy manifesting in a millions of different ways. Or experientially, if you look at it, what you exhale right now, the trees are inhaling. What they exhale, we are inhaling. What this means is, one half of the lung is hanging out there. Yes, one half of your lungs is hanging out there, isn't it? The whole breathing mechanism is not here. Only one part is here, another part is out there. If we experientially knew this, nobody had to tell us to save the environment, don't cut the tree. All this would be rubbish for us if we only experienced this. So, it is common knowledge, at least in your high school textbook, that you are not some kind of a freak happening. You are just a part of the universe, you're also just one more happening. And it's a part of everything else. So union means in your experience, you… if you sit here, there's only you. The whole existence is just you. So you are capable of experiencing something that is not you as yourself if only a certain level of inclusiveness happens within you. Your inclusiveness right now is limited to your physicality. If this inclusiveness can be extended beyond physical nature, suddenly you can sit here, experience the whole universe as yourself. If this happens to you, then we say you are in yoga. So why the physical posture came is, maybe many of you are not old enough for this, but if you saw the televisions in 70s when it first came, you had that little aluminum contraption over your home. You remember that? Antenna? You're watching like this, suddenly your television boop, 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 boop. Then somebody went up on the terrace and now, gently like this. Get into the right place, once again the world pours into your sitting room. Yes or no? Just if you get it to the right place, this is just like that. If you learn to just hold this body right, if you know how to hold it right, you can download the whole cosmos into this. This is Hatha Yoga.
yoga is not twisting and turning. You can change the fundamentals of who you are. You don't have to do anything on the yoga mat. Without that, you can transform the fundamentals by doing… making your life into yoga. One way of looking at yoga is, one meaning of yoga is, that which renders you to a higher possibility in your life is yoga. So, it is best that people approach this in a different way. So, my approach to this is that we must bring the awareness of the profound possibility of yoga. Yoga is a much subtler dimension. It needs to be handled in an extremely committed atmosphere, and you have to be precise in the way you approach it. Otherwise, what can fundamentally transform your life if it's mishandled, it can do certain things. It's like we can't think of living without electricity right now. It's making our lives in every way. So you love it so much, you go and stick your little finger into that hole in the wall, then it does something else. So anything that is capable of transforming our lives, we must understand, if something has the power to transform, it has the power to cause damage if mishandled. So instead of trying yoga, I would say, if somebody wants to rapidly learn something, there is a dimension of yoga which is called as upa yoga. That means it's pre-yoga or sub-yoga. The word upa yoga in vernacular languages in India has come to mean something useful now, but actually it means, upa yoga means sub-yoga or pre-yoga. So this pre-yoga, we are seeing how to make it popular. You're not looking for any spiritual possibility. You just want to physically be a little better, mentally little limbered up and this. For this, we have a simple schedule of upa yoga. You can learn this in 3 minutes yoga you want to do, you can do. You want to do 6 minutes yoga, you can do. This is all upa yoga, this is not yoga. So probably this is something that large segments of the world, even those people who are involved in yoga, are not aware that there's another possibility of doing semi-yoga, something that gives you physical and psychological benefits but doesn't touch the spiritual dimension as yet. After you feel physically, mentally well and you still see life is not fulfilled, then you can seek the spiritual process. So, one dimension of what we want to do for this thing is to make upa yoga popular, because this can be taught. This can be taught on the street, this can be taught anywhere, and you can practice it anywhere, in any posture, whichever way, and the benefits will be quite immense. But it will not demand the level of commitment that yoga demands, nor does it cause any problem if you do it improperly, because you can't do it improperly.
我们要来学习七套瑜伽，健康、成功、平和、幸福、喜悦、内在维度和爱。现在我们将开始一步步学习乌帕瑜伽。以下是一些指导建议，他们会为你的练习创造最佳条件，大大增强你的练习效果。接下来的一个小时中，请全身心投入练习中。确保手机处于静音或关机状态，最好避免中途起身、吃东西、喝水或上洗手间。请不要在饱腹状态或吃饭后立刻练习，最好是略有饥饿感、半空腹或空腹状态。请保持脊柱舒适挺直的坐姿，双手摊开，掌心朝上。这些做法有助于提高你的接收能力，并从练习中获得最佳效果。这些练习非常安全简单，任何人都可练习。有慢性疾病、疼痛、心血管疾病的人士，请在练习前咨询医生，多加谨慎。请按照指示，缓慢而轻柔地进行练习。做任何练习时，如有任何不适，请跳过那个练习，直接进入下一个练习。如果你有感到疼痛或不适，请停止练习，并咨询医生。这些练习适合任何7岁以上的人士。如 如果你戴眼镜，练习时请摘掉。
Yoga for health, directional movement. When you lie in horizontal postures for a few hours during sleep, the lubricating fluids in your joints tend to settle down and are not in circulation. So when you wake up, body is demanding, you first lubricate your joints. Directional movement is a simple way of doing this. It also exercises the muscles without any risk of injury. Joints have a concentration of energy nodules, so by activating them, everything in the system gets ignited for action.
现在我们要学的练习叫手臂定向移动，一共有四个方向。我们先来看第一个方向的示范，请留心观察。双脚舒适分开，脚的内侧互相平行，闭上眼睛。随着吸气，把手带到肩膀前方，这是起始姿势。第一个方向是两侧，随着呼气，手臂向两侧伸展，手腕向外旋转。手臂完全伸直后，随着吸气收回手臂，现在手腕要向内旋转。这是一个回合，要做三个回合。注意，旋转手腕的同时，你的手也要一张一合。手臂肌肉要紧绷，像是在推一个重物那样。手臂尽可能的绷紧，但身体其他部位保持放松。当你的手臂向外伸展时，手腕总是随着呼气向外旋转。当你的手臂向内收回时，手腕总是随着吸气向内旋转。现在我们一起来做三个回合，请站起来，确保你周围有足够的空间，双脚舒适地分开，脚的内侧互相平行，闭上眼睛，随着吸气把手带到肩膀正前方，这是起始姿势。随着呼气，向左右两侧伸展手臂，手腕应向外旋转。手臂完全伸直后，随着吸气收回手臂。现在你的手腕应该向内旋转。这是一个回合，我们再做两个回合。第二个回合，不仅要旋转手腕，你的手也应该一张一合，手臂尽可能的绷紧，但身体其他部位要放松。第三个回合，手臂向外伸展时，手腕总是随着呼气向外旋转。手臂向内收时，手腕总是随着吸气向内旋转。做完后，请放松，并舒适地坐着。现在我们来看几个常见的更正。再次说明， 手臂向外伸展时，手腕总是向外旋转。这是向外。手臂向内收回时，手腕总是向内旋转，这是向内。不要做得太快或太随意，慢慢地做，并尽可能绷紧你的手臂，但身体其他部位要保持放松。我们学习了一个方向，现在我们来看看其他三个方向是怎样做的。请留心观察。起始姿势，手放在肩膀前方，闭上眼睛。第一个方向是两侧，随着呼气，向左右两侧伸展你的手臂，手腕向外旋转。随着吸气，收回手臂，同时手腕向内旋转。注意手臂和肩膀总是保持同等高度。这是一个回合，这样做三次。第二个方向是向前，随着呼气，手臂向前伸展，手腕向外旋转。手臂完全伸直后，随着吸气收回手臂。现在手腕应该向内旋转。整个过程手臂尽可能的绷紧。这是一个回合，这样做三次。第三个方向是向上，随着呼气手臂向上伸展，手腕向外旋转。然后随着吸气收回手臂，手腕向内旋转。这是一个回合，这样做三次。第四个方向是向下，随着呼气手臂向下伸展，手腕向外旋转。手臂完全伸展后，收回手臂，手腕向内旋转。这是一个回合，这样做三次。现在我们每个方向都做三个回合，请站起来。起始姿势，两脚舒适地分开，检查一下双脚是否互相平行，手放在肩膀的正前方，确保头正直朝向前方，眼睛闭上。第一个方向是两侧，随着呼气手臂向两侧伸展，手腕向外旋转。随着吸气收回手臂，手腕向内旋转。第二个回合，随着呼气伸展手臂，确保手臂与肩膀始终保持一致高度。随着吸气收回手臂。第三个回合，伸展手臂的时候是完全的呼气，收回手臂的时候是完全的吸气。 当你回到起始姿势后，换方向，第二个方向是向前。随着呼气，向前伸展手臂，手腕应该向外旋转。手臂完全伸直后，随着吸气收回手臂。现在手腕应该向内旋转。第二个回合，确保手臂尽量绷紧。第三个回合，旋转手腕时，手也要一张一合。手打开时，五个手指都应该分开。第三个方向是向上，随着呼气，手臂向上伸展，手腕向外旋转。同样的，随着吸气收回手臂，手腕向内旋转。第二个回合，第三个回合，不要做得太快，慢慢的带着意识去做。第四个方向是向下，随着呼气，手臂向下伸展，手腕向外旋转。随着吸气收回手臂，现在你的手腕应该向内旋转。第二个回合，不要屏住呼吸。第三个回合，手应该在身体的两旁，肩膀的正下方移动。完成后，你可以放松手臂，舒适地坐下。
Yoga for Success, the neck practices.Both the neurological and the energy systems branch out in a big way between the shoulder blades and above. So keeping the neck region in a good condition is very important. Within 3 to 4 minutes of doing these neck practices, you will distinctly see that you are much more alert and the lethargy in the body will be obliterated. There is a higher level of neuronal regeneration.Memory and intellectual sharpness also improves.
现在我们来做几个颈部练习，这将有利于放松肩颈部位的肌肉。我们先来看前三个练习，请留心观察。双脚舒适分开，脚的内侧互相平行，手臂肩膀放松。你的脖子应该松弛的像一条绳子，没有任何的僵硬。闭上眼睛，随着呼气，慢慢的把下巴带到胸口，这是起始姿势。随着吸气，慢慢的抬头，然后向后仰。随着呼气，把下巴带回胸口。这是一个回合， 这样做三次。现在我们来看第二个颈部练习。随着吸气，慢慢地把头转向右边，转到极点，随着呼气回到正中，再随着吸气，慢慢地把头转向左边，转到极点，随着呼气回到正中。这是一个回合，这样做三次。现在我们来学习第三个颈部练习。随着呼气，慢慢地把右耳尽量地靠向右肩，随着吸气回到正中，再随着呼气，慢慢地把左耳尽量地靠向左肩，随着吸气回到正中。这是一个回合，这样做三次。现在我们一起来做这三个颈部练习，每个练习做三个回合。请站起来，双脚舒适分开，脚的内侧互相平行，手臂肩膀放松，闭上眼睛，随着呼气，慢慢地把下巴带到胸口，这是起始姿势。随着吸气，慢慢地抬头，然后尽量向后仰。随着呼气，把下巴带回胸口。第二个回合，吸气，抬头后仰。呼气，下巴回到胸口。第三个回合，确保肩膀手臂放松。第二个颈部练习，回到起始姿势，头正直朝向前方，闭上眼睛，随着吸气，慢慢地把头转向右边，随着呼气，回到正中。再随着吸气，慢慢地把头转向左边，随着呼气，回到正中。第二个回合，右边。左边。第三个回合，慢慢地做，你可以停留拉伸一会儿，再回来。回到起始姿势。我们来做第三个颈部练习，确保你的头是平直的，闭上眼睛。随着呼气，慢慢地把右耳靠向右肩，随着吸气，回到正中，再随着呼气，慢慢地把左耳靠向左肩，随着吸气，回到正中。第二个回合， 第三个回合，头靠向肩膀时是呼气，回到正中时是吸气。做完以后，请舒适地坐下。现在我们来学习第四和第五个颈部练习。双脚舒适分开，脚的内侧互相平行，闭上眼睛。随着呼气，把下巴带到胸口。这是起始姿势。随着吸气，慢慢地把头转向右肩，然后绕一圈。吸气，头向后。呼气，头向前，然后换方向，向反方向再绕一圈。这是一个回合，要做三次。现在我们来看最后一个，第五个颈部练习。向前旋转你的肩膀，吸气提肩。呼气放下，这样做三次。现在向后旋转你的肩膀，吸气提肩，呼气放下，这样再做三次。那现在我们一起来做第四个和第五个颈部练习。请站起来，检查一下你的脚是否互相平行，闭上眼睛。随着呼气，把下巴带到胸口。这是起始姿势。随着吸气，慢慢地把头转向右肩。吸气，头向后。呼气，头向前，完整的绕一圈，然后换方向，向反方向旋转一周。我们来再做两个回合，第二个回合，把头转向右肩，绕一圈。确保上半身保持不动。换方向向左转。绕一圈。第三个回合，慢慢地做。和呼吸配合。现在我们一起来做第五个练习。头保持正直，上半身放松，闭上眼睛。肩膀向前旋转，吸气提肩，呼气放下。这样做三次。 现在肩膀向后旋转，吸气提肩，呼气放下，这样做三次。做完以后，舒适地坐着。
Yoga for well-being. Yoga Namaskar. Yoga Namaskar is a powerful system by itself. It activates the lumbar region of the spine in a tremendous way, strengthens the muscles along the spine, giving it a reinforcement so that as one ages, the collapsing of the spine, which causes pinching of the nerves, does not happen. And if already there's damage is setting in, the best way to regenerate your spine would be by doing Yoga Namaskar. It has all-round benefits for the entire body. Yoga Namaskar is a very simple and complete process by itself.
练习瑜伽合十里需要半空腹状态，也就是吃完正餐后一个半小时。如果您不符合这个条件，请跳过这个练习。患有疝气或处于三四个月孕期的女士，请不要练习。我们现在要学的练习叫瑜伽合十里，一共有七个步骤，它会示范一整套练习，请留心观察。双脚舒适分开，脚的内侧互相平行。手臂肩膀放松，眼睛张开，专注于眼前的一个点。目光稳定后，双手合十放在胸前，这是起始姿势。随着吸气，把双手带上头顶。随着呼气，双手向下移，手掌根部移到脖子后方。随着吸气，把双手带上头顶。随着呼气，双手回到胸前。这是第一步。这样再做两次。第二步，呼气时要从喉咙根部发出声音，第三步，整个过程手指合拢，指尖朝上，包括你的手在脖子后面的时候，手向上的时候要完全的吸气，手向下的时候要完全的呼气，同时从喉咙底部发出声音，这样做三次后蹲下来。第四步，随着吸气把手带上头顶，随着呼气把手移到脖子后面，吸气，手向上，呼气，回到胸前，再吸气，向前伸直双手，指尖朝向前方，呼气，伴随着喉咙根部发出的声音，把手带回胸前，这样做三次。第五步，随着吸气把手带上头顶，随着呼气把手移到脖子后方，吸气向上，呼气回到胸前，吸气向前伸直，呼气回到胸前。再做一次。第六步，吸气向上， 呼气向下，吸气上，呼气下，吸气向前伸直，呼气回到胸前。第七步，随着吸气，双手向前伸出，跪下，身体前倾，额头着地，手臂伸到头顶前方，双手拇指和食指碰在一起形成一个三角形，手肘略微弯曲，这是婴儿式，停在这里，直到呼吸平稳，或至少两分钟。然后慢慢站起来，回到起始姿势。这是一个回合。我们来看一些常见的更正。如果你下蹲的时候有困难，可以在脚跟下垫一个半英寸或一英寸的垫子，然后再蹲下，确保双脚要平行。有些人手放到脖子后面的时候，手指会朝向后方，整个过程手指都应该朝上。还有一些人会低头，头应该正直朝向前方。手的移动不要太快或太随意。而应该略带紧绷。结合刚才的更正，我们现在一起来做一个回合。请站起来，确保前面有足够的空间，双脚舒适分开，脚的内侧互相平行。需要垫子帮助下蹲的话，可以先把垫子放在脚后面，这样做第四步的时候可以直接后退一步踩在垫子上。眼睛张开，专注于眼前的一个点，目光稳定后，双手合十放在胸前。这是起始姿势。第一步，随着吸气把手带上头顶，随着呼气把手移到脖子后方，吸气，手臂向上伸直，呼气，把手带回胸前，这样再做两次。第二步，吸气，手向上，呼气，从喉咙根部发声的同时，把手移到脖子后方，吸气，手向上，呼气，回到胸前。第三步，吸气，手向上，呼气，手移到脖子后方，吸气，手向上，呼气，手回到胸前。现在蹲下来，如果需要的话，可以拿垫子作为辅助，专注于眼前的一个点。第四步，吸气，把手带上头顶，呼气，把手带到脖子后方，吸气，向上，呼气，回到胸前，吸气，双手向前伸直，呼气，回到胸前，这样再做两次。第五步， 随着吸气，把手带上头顶。随着呼气，把手移到脖子后方。吸气向上，呼气回到胸前。吸气向前伸直，呼气回到胸前。第六步，吸气向上，呼气向下，吸气上，呼气下，吸气向前伸直，呼气回到胸前。第七步，随着吸气，双手向前伸出，跪下，身体前倾，额头着地，脚背着地，坐在脚跟上，手臂伸到头顶前方，手掌平放在地上休息，双手拇指和食指碰在一起，形成一个三角形，手肘略微弯曲，停在这里，直至呼吸平稳，或至少两分钟。然后慢慢站起来，回到起始姿势。做完以后，请舒适地坐下。你在家自己练习瑜伽和室里时，可以做三个回合，这样效果会更好。
Yoga for peace, Nadi Shuddhi. The word Nadi Shuddhi literally means cleansing the nadis. When we say nadis, we are not talking about the 72,000, because these 72,000 are only a branch out of the two basic nadis, the Pingala and the Ida. 36,000 branching out from Pingala, 36,000 branching out from Ida. This is the energy physiology of a human being. When we say Nadi Shuddhi, we are talking about cleansing fundamentally the Pingala and Ida so that energy system will work in balance. There is a connection between your breath and your mental structure. To bring balance to your thought is a very important step that you need to take if you want to bring balance to your activity, your emotion, and the results of your life, and the impact that you have on other people's lives.
接下来要学习的练习叫气脉净化，请看示范。盘腿而坐，脊柱舒适挺直，闭上眼睛，左手舒适地放在两腿中央，手掌朝上，只用你的右手大拇指和无名指折叠中指和食指，无名指和小拇指伸直并拢。先用大拇指按住右鼻孔，通过左鼻孔吸气，完全吸满后，继续通过左鼻孔呼气，然后用无名指按住左鼻孔，通过右鼻孔吸气，完全吸满后，继续通过右鼻孔呼气。完全呼出后，堵住右鼻孔，通过左鼻孔吸、呼，再堵住左鼻孔，通过右鼻孔吸、呼，这样继续下去。注意力放在呼吸上，你做这个呼吸控制法的时候，最重要的一点是要完全的吸，完全的呼，尽可能的缓慢轻柔。呼吸的时候不要发出任何声音，你可以记住永远都是呼气完再换鼻孔，也就是说你通过一个鼻孔吸气后，再通过同一个鼻孔呼气。 这个练习至少做四分钟。这里有几个常见的更正。不要把左手放在大腿上，左手应该舒适地放在两腿中央。再次强调，只用右手的大拇指和无名指，无名指和小拇指要伸直并拢，如果伸不直，尽量即可。折叠中指和食指。不要低头或把头扭向一边。有些人不自觉地会把头转向一边。头应该保持正直，这样有助于你的系统更快达到平衡。注意不要太用力地去按鼻孔，只需轻轻地按住膈中鼻软骨下方1毫米处，你就可以有效地阻止空气流通。呼吸不能太浅，也不要只是正常呼吸或屏住呼吸，应该完全的吸满，再完全的呼出。我们现在一起来做气脉净化。盘腿而坐，脊柱舒适挺直。如果你无法坐在地上，可以坐在椅子上，交叉双脚。左手放松地放在两腿中间，手掌朝上，只用右手的大拇指和无名指，无名指和小拇指伸直并拢，折叠中指和食指。闭上眼睛，先用大拇指按住右鼻孔，通过左鼻孔吸气，完全吸满后，继续通过左鼻孔呼气，然后用无名指按住左鼻孔，通过右鼻孔吸气，完全吸满后，继续通过右鼻孔呼气。完全呼出后，再按住右鼻孔，通过左鼻孔吸、呼，这样继续做下去，直到叫你停止。注意力放在呼吸上。呼吸要完全的吸，完全的呼。呼吸要尽量缓慢而轻柔。确保脊柱舒适挺直。头要保持正直，继续专注于呼吸。 请通过左鼻孔呼气，停止练习，慢慢地睁开眼睛。
Yoga for joy, not the yoga. Modern science is proving to you the whole existence is just a reverberation. Where there is a reverberation, there is bound to be a sound. So the whole existence is sound. The root sounds for this complex amalgamation of sounds are a, oo, and mm. Without employing your tongue, you would be able to make only these three sounds, a, woo, and ma. By placing your tongue in different positions within the cavity of your mouth, you get to mix these three sounds and produce all the other sounds. A, woo, and mm are the basis of all the other sounds that you can utter. They are referred to as the basic sounds or the universal sounds. If you utter these three sounds together, you get the sound om. These are the only three sounds that the system can produce naturally. If you utter these three sounds carefully, different aspects of your body are activated and energized. You will notice if you utter the sound ah, the reverberation starts just beneath the navel and will spread right across the body, because this is the only place where all the 72,000 nadis or pathways of energy meet and redistribute themselves. This is the maintenance center in the body. Uttering the sound ah strengthens this. If you utter the sound oo, you will notice this point where the rib cage meets, just beneath that, there is a soft spot. The reverberations will flow from here and then move upward. If you utter the sound mm, you will see the reverberations will start from the pit of your throat and generally spread to the upper regions of your body. Uttering these three sounds has innumerable benefits. If you are suffering from any psychological disturbances like excessive fear, nightmares, or unstable mind or body, if your general constitution is weak, you tend to fall sick too often, particularly for children who have attention disorders, daily utterance of these sounds for a few minutes a day will make an enormous difference. Uttering of these three fundamental sounds activates the three lobes of your lungs separately, which in turn activates the three basic segments of the body, the lower, the middle, and the upper, laying the necessary foundation for the pleasantness of your being or for a joyful existence. Sit in a cross-legged posture. Place your palms facing upward upon your thighs. Listen to the instructions carefully before you start the practice. Open your mouth wide enough and utter the sound completely exhaling into the sound. We'll do this 7 times. Then shape your lips in the form of a circle and utter the sound completely exhaling into the sound. We'll do this 7 times. Then, by closing your mouth, utter the sound mm. You utter the sound 7 times. As you do this, notice where the reverberations are happening. In which region of the body? Sound A generates reverberations around your navel. Sound U at the point where the rib cage meets, and sound M will center around the pit of your throat. Now let us do it together. Keep your palms facing upward, your spine comfortably erect. Please close your eyes. Oh. take your own time.
慢慢的
take your own time.
慢慢的
slowly, very slowly.
睁开眼睛
open your eyes. Yoga for inner exploration. Shambhavi Mudra. In the history of humanity, many truly scintillating human beings have happened. They have shone brighter than the stars in the sky. But why is it that one seems to have come with enormous capability, and why is it another has to struggle with every little aspect of life? If you consider yourself to be a mechanism, you have a body and a mind. You may have a great body and a great mind, but what you call as grace is the lubrication. Without the necessary lubrication, you get stuck at every point. Any number of people like this are there on this planet, intelligent, capable, but at every corner in their life, they get stuck because there is no lubrication. So it is important for a human being to have an element of grace in their lives. Shambhavi Mudra is a process that is like opening a window so that one becomes receptive to grace. Sit comfortably in a cross-legged posture. Keep your spine comfortably erect. We will hold Yoga Mudra. Make the thumb and the index finger come together at the very tips, forming a circle between them. Let the other three fingers be straight, all the four fingers together without any gap between them. Holding the mudra facing upwards upon your thigh, arms and shoulders should be loose and relaxed. Close your eyes and sit with a slightly upturned face. When you sit with your face slightly upturned, there is a natural focus between your eyebrows. Maintain this natural focus, do not concentrate, just maintain this natural focus between your eyebrows and sit with your face slightly upturned. Eyes closed.
把注意力自然地放在双眉之间，有意识地关注每一个自然的呼吸。
Conscious of the natural moment of breath. For 3 to 6 minutes. Yogaratova Bogaratova Sangaratova Sangavihinaha Yasya Brahmani Ramate Chitta Yasya Brahmani Ramate Chitta Nandati Nandati Nandate Va Nandati Nandati Nandate Va Take
慢慢的
your own time.
慢慢的
Take your own time.
睁开眼睛
slowly, Very slowly. Open your eyes. Yoga for love, Namaskar process. The word yoga means union, union of all polarities, of masculine and feminine, yin and yang, individual and universal, Shiva Shakti, right brain and left brain, or whatever else you may want to call them. To achieve this blessed union, the simplest formis the yoga of Namaskar. Putting the two hands together in alignment with each other at the level of your heart will bring you to a certain harmony between polarities within. That in turn brings a sense of being united with whoever or whatever the Namaskar is aimed at. In placing your hands together,the dualities of your likes and dislikes, your cravings and aversions are leveled out, and there is a certain oneness to the experience of who you are. For a few minutes every day, put your hands together in Namaskar, look upon someone or something that means much to you. Maybe the sun, the moon, the clouds, the empty sky, the trees, the rock, your husband,your wife, your child, your mother, father, or a picture that matters to you. Look at that someone or something with the highest level of emotion that you can generate. In an attitude of loving attention, hold Namaskar for 3 to 5 minutes. Your life will be on a transformational mode.